the issues of the joint challenges I would like to raise is the question of the monetization of elections.
Elections are nowhere perfect. I don't have to quote examples here. You can just read the international press. Even in my country, we have people criticizing our electoral process. But it can be improved. Now, that is the thing we feel is lacking in Uganda. In the past years, we have not seen these improvements, which are absolutely needed. I give one example, and a very important example. You know, young people, the constitution grants the right for every Ugandan 18 years or older to vote. Now, in the practice, the electoral law and the electoral commission do not grant them that right. You have to be 19 and above because of some administrative rules, the registration of voters. All persons who were not 18 in December last year, 14 months before the elections, they will not be able to vote. This is a huge number.
The register of the Independent Electoral Commission should be available in time, first for display, but also to confirm to the members that they are or not. I don't think anybody who is not in the register will be able to vote. Now, on the electoral forms, yes, we read the observer reports for the last 15 years. If it was within our power, Parliament would have voted on those amendments. In fact, Parliament had our own proposals for reform. Unfortunately, we operate in a system where, under the Constitution, that work can only come from the central government. We are not allowed to move bills or motions that will have an impact on the consolidated fund unless the government has permitted us to do so. Yes, we want reforms, but we are hampered by Article 93 of the Constitution and the practice here.